Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We'll soon be commencing our ceremony. May I ask that everybody checks their mobile phones, make sure they're either on silent or turned off, please. Today's graduation procession will be led by the students, followed by members of council, academic staff, guests, including Her Excellency Professor Kate Warner, AC, Governor of Tasmania, and Mr. Warner. I'll ask that you to stand to welcome the procession, please. Thank you.
Would you please stand for the national anthem? Please be seated. Your Excellency, Professor Kate Warner, Governor of Tasmania, Mr. Richard Warner, graduating students, College Council colleagues, principal, college staff, and ladies and gentlemen. It is my great privilege and honour to welcome you to the Marcus Oldham 2018 graduation ceremony. We celebrate the very diverse geographical location of our students across the breadth of our wonderful continent, who come to hone their skills studying the college's equine, agriculture and agribusiness courses. We thank those of you who have travelled great distances to support your graduate today, and take a moment to pause and think of our colleagues who are enduring ongoing difficult seasonal conditions. Farming is always a challenging profession and mostly very rewarding. I trust those of you who attended yesterday's Life After Marcus seminar at the college found it useful to focus on the future of your businesses with a new stream of ideas and experiences being thrust upon them. We trust that the knowledge gained by our students and the contacts and friendships they have made will prepare them in their chosen field within this very competitive world, in which equine management and agriculture and its production systems are undergoing much closer scrutiny and publicity. The live animal export trade and the sport horse activities are examples of where the social license is publicly under review, and very easily false pictorial and verbal information receives extreme publicity. The need for effective, vigilant welfare standards is paramount. Our educational program is the reason for the college's existence. Marcus Oldham has, once again, rated highly in the federal government's quality indicators for learning and teaching. This survey rates the overall quality of the educational experience and the teaching quality across all higher education institutions. These results are a wonderful tribute and recognition of the quality and dedication of our lecturing team and the engagement of the students in the college programs. The annual Marcus Oldham Rural Leadership Program was a highlight of the external courses. This is now a course subject available for the Master of Agribusiness students as part of their leadership unit of study. The Centre for the Study of Agribusiness held a solid program of forums for the students at the college. The centre is involved in developing a pilot program utilising up-to-date financial data to showcase agribusiness trends and the analysis of farm performance results from the Southwest Monitor Project, which have some 20 years of data behind them. A well-attended business luncheon was held in Melbourne at which the guest speaker was Emma Weston, Chief Executive Officer of AgriDigital, who introduced blockchain trading platforms to a fascinated audience enthralled by this developing technology. The college continues to strive to enhance the infrastructure. Last year, we completed the redesigning of Lecture Room 4, This, I understand, has been a great success, with the lecturers and the students enjoying the revitalised lecture room environment and all the technological advances this incorporates. This learning space has informed the development of the largest building project undertaken by Marcus Oldham College, the Learning Centre. After a very lengthy planning process, the contract was let to a Geelong construction company, and thus far the project, which is due to be completed in late 2019, is on time and on budget. Long may that continue. The College Foundation has had a busy year, which included conducting the annual golf day and the Foundation cocktail party, which acknowledges the scholarship holders and the sponsors of the scholarships. This gathering was addressed by the Honourable Geoffrey Kennett, who outlined the importance of the agricultural and water policy politically. He is also widely recognised for his significant contributions to organisations dealing with mental health issues. The Foundation Executive has contributed a great deal to the We Need Great Minds campaign, which is raising funds for the construction of the Learning Centre. The funding and coordination of the scholarship program has been managed and enhanced by Janet Craigie McConnell. Janet, after 30 years of dedicated service to the college, has decided to retire. We are indebted to Janet in many ways, none more than the editor's role of the Makosa magazine, which has kept the Marcus alumni informed of many graduates' fascinating achievements and stories. We salute you, Janet. Thank you also for the compilation of the minutes from the council and associated committees, all cobbled together in great accurate detail. The College Council and the Principal very seriously take the role of extending pastoral care to our staff and students. We are very cognisant of the fact that a great collegiate atmosphere and student wellbeing is generated from within the college. And whilst not being overly restrictive, we need a strong set of behavioural guidelines. I believe we have those in place for the ongoing wellbeing of the community. To that end, we acknowledge the contributions of the principal, the domestic staff, academic and administration staff, and the student executive. An army marches on its nutrition, and I thank Lynn Cameron, manager of catering and accommodation, and her team for the happy manner in which the hostel is conducted. It must be a great relief when the year is over and the campus returns to solitude, and then the annual cleaning process commences. Our thanks to Lynn and her team. Having read the news yesterday of the closure of the Emerald and Longreach Ag Colleges in Queensland, we consider we must have a reasonable recipe for success at this college. I think that those closures have invoked a lot of anger, but they weren't very well supported. And so we're very proud, and for the future of the college, our future enrolments are looking very good. I warmly thank my college council colleagues for their support throughout the year. The building project has consumed much time, and I especially mention James Bufton and acknowledge his untiring effort as the chair of the Planning and Building and Facilities Committee, and thank him for his role in the ongoing coordination of the construction of the Learning Centre. Earlier this year, James retired as the president of the Marcus Oldham Students Association. After 18 years of dedicated service to the organisation that does so much to keep the past students in touch. Peter Stevens, who's with us today, has assumed the mantle, and we congratulate him and wish him well in this very significant role. James is probably currently fighting the fire out at Little River, so our thoughts are especially with him today. In July this year, the council held its off-campus meeting in Toowoomba, Queensland. We had some very informative technical visits, and in the evening hosted a function which was attended by almost 100 guests, including alumni and others associated with the college. It is certainly very rewarding to catch up with graduates all over Australia, and we really appreciate that many revel in the friendships that commenced at Marcus, and they appreciate the value of this support base. I thank the student executive, which under the leadership of student president Jack Courts has supported the student body well and contributed significantly to life on the campus. The students and parents charity dinner held in July at the pier in Geelong was an outstanding networking and fundraising event. We honour and congratulate the graduating students gathered here today. You are a member of the Marcus Oldham community, and when you wear the Marcus emblem, wear it proudly. You'll be scrutinised a little harder when you wear this in amongst your communities. In life, it is far more rewarding to be a participator rather than a spectator or commentator. Good luck with your future, and generally, you create your own good luck with your own efforts. Always remember that you are part of the Marcus family. I now call on the Principal, Dr. Simon Livingston.
Your Excellency, College Chairman, members of Council, staff, graduating students, ladies and gentlemen. I join with Mr. Wilson in welcoming you to this graduation ceremony, and particularly the parents, relatives, and guests of the graduates, many of whom have travelled thousands of kilometres to be here today. And I'd like to acknowledge the attendance of two past principals, Graham McConnell and Greg Brinsmead, who are with us. Let me first acknowledge what is clearly the central focus of today's proceedings, a profound message of congratulations to the graduates as they celebrate both individually and collectively the results of their own hard work and dedication. The achievement in reaching graduation must not be underestimated. Tertiary study takes time and commitment. To get to this point, many people have made sacrifices. I acknowledge the strong support you have received from your parents, partners and friends whilst you have studied at Marcus Oldham. 2018 has been a busy and productive year as outlined by our college chairman. The development of the college is very much a team effort. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank our academic, administrative, maintenance and catering and accommodation staff for their support. The academic year has been a busy one, and I thank all staff for working with me to ensure the year was a great success. The College Council has been very supportive, and I thank them for their encouragement and advice throughout the year. The Student Executive, comprising Jack Courts, Will Ferguson, Sally Conway, Kate Crozier, Megan Webb and Will Ricardo, has worked hard to develop the student community over the year, and I thank them for their efforts. The College was fortunate to have secured another year of solid enrolments at a time when most states and territories have been experiencing widespread drought. There has been significant publicity in the media about the crippling drought and the devastation it is causing farmers and their communities. The debate will continue whether handouts to farmers will address this problem or whether more considered long-term strategies are required. One investment, however, that does assist when droughts occur is education. I recently visited the Longreach Barcolden district in Queensland and called in on a Marcus graduate who was pregnancy testing Santa Gertrudis cows on his family properties. What struck me most was how good condition the cows were in for a district that has been in severe drought for over 6 years. Apart from some supplementary lick that was located throughout the paddocks, the cattle were not receiving any additional feed. The cattle were well suited to the district and the conditions, but it became evident to me that the management decisions being made on the property were key to handling the drought. Similarly, the feedback I received from lecturers who recently visited our practical year students is that many of the students are learning the practicalities and the reality of farming in drought conditions, and that the leading farmers have well considered strategies to manage adversity. Like any business, it's about making sound management decisions during the hard times that make the difference. Having studied farm management at Marcus Oldham will not alleviate the drought, but will assist farmers of the future to make informed decisions relating to their business. The annual student parent dinner was held in July with 330 people attending. The evening was a great success and clearly was well supported by both students and parents. The event, which was organised by the students, raised $18,000, which was donated to the Dolly's Dream Foundation, a foundation that aims to raise awareness of the impact of bullying, mental health, and youth suicide. In October, the student community organised a fundraiser to support research for a cure for motor neuron disease, as members of the college community have lost family to this disease. Throughout the year, students also donated several thousand dollars to the local CFA. Congratulations to our students for your significant community service through the year. 2018 has seen several reunion groups visit the campus and reminisce about their time at Marcus Oldham. For many graduates, the college has had a significant positive influence on their personal development and has greatly assisted them to forge aspiring careers. Reunions are a great way for alumni to reconnect with both their year group and the college. To our graduates today, there are many opportunities before you. I am sure you do not need me to tell you about the competitive world which you are entering, a world in which geographical boundaries have become increasingly irrelevant as we move towards a truly global economy. You will enter that competition with the advantage of a qualification from Marcus Oldham. It is up to you to decide what you want to do with your life and what you wish to achieve. We all have different expectations of ourselves. At this point in your career, you do not know your full capabilities and what you will be doing and achieving in 10, 15 or 20 years' time. However, one thing is certain: situations will change and opportunities will present themselves. It will be up to you to decide which direction you wish to take. I wish you all well in the judgment calls you will have to make over the course of your careers and indeed your lives, and I wish you well in looking ahead rather than looking back. Today, you can justly look back with pride on your achievement on becoming graduates of Marcus Oldham, but it is much more important to look forward. I want to encourage you all to look ahead, imagine the kind of world you want, and do your best to make it happen. Finally, I've enjoyed working with all of you, and I and the staff and council wish you well in your future endeavours. We hope that your education serves you well, and we wish you every success in the future. I now ask Peter Stevens, President of the Past Students Association, to present the charge, and I ask all graduates to please rise for the charge.
Thank you, Principal. The high standards already achieved by the graduates of Marcus Oldham College are recognised both nationally and internationally. The college, therefore, reaffirms its commitment to leadership and excellence in the fields of agriculture, agribusiness and equine management. Graduates of 2018, the council, staff and alumni charge you with the responsibility of conducting yourselves in a manner which is appropriate for a graduate of Marcus Oldham College. You will demonstrate this by your professional approach in your chosen profession, your leadership and involvement both in your industry and within your community, and your stewardship to ensure the viability and sustainability of the resources you manage. 2018 graduates, this is your charge. Please be seated.
I ask Your Excellency to present the graduates with their awards. I now invite Emma Morell, Director of Equine Management, to announce the equine graduates.
Your Excellency, the following students have satisfied the requirements for the Diploma of Equine Management. Kate Amanda Austin, Queensland. Sophie Rose Barber, Victoria. Natalie Ann Barton, New South Wales. Cassandra Evans, South Australia. Georgia Ann Everingham, New South Wales. Zoe Anna Greenslade, Victoria. Brianna Ellen Harcourt, Tasmania. Chelsea Hardy, Victoria. Claire Ellen Hensley, Queensland. Maggie Johnston, Victoria. Danielle Laurie, Victoria. Isabel Rose Mackey, Victoria. Naomi Amber Mavrikas, Victoria. Hannah Micah, Victoria. Katrina Ann O'Driscoll, Victoria. Madeline Clare O'Meara, New South Wales. Caitlin Reed, Tasmania. Alyssa Kate Rogers, South Australia. Lucy Nicole Sanders, Victoria. Olympia Beata Santa Maria, Victoria. Courtney Summons, New South Wales. Tage Weir, Victoria. Caitlin Westwick, Victoria. Your Excellency, the Henry Dwyer Racing Award for Equine Business Management is awarded to Olympia Santa Maria. The Ballarat Veterinary Practice Award for Horse Husbandry and Horse Health is awarded to Hannah Micah. The Marcus Oldham Old College Association Award for Practical Skills is awarded to Zoe Greenslade. The Marcus Oldham Principal's Award for Effort and Achievement is awarded to Tage Weir. The Mustad Saddle World Award to the Ducks of the Diploma of Equine Management is awarded to Hannah Micah. Please congratulate the Diploma of Equine Management 2018 graduates as they leave the stage. Thank you.
I now invite Andrew Baker, Director of Agribusiness and Agriculture, to announce the agribusiness graduates.
Your Excellency, the following students have satisfied the requirement for the Diploma of Agribusiness. Lily Emma Bingham from Victoria. Logan Helen Brown from Victoria. Joseph William Burgess from New South Wales. Michael Close from Victoria. Callum Christopher Conan from Victoria. James Oliver Cusack from Victoria. Maxwell Ian Cameron Davies from New South Wales. Kate Marie Jury from Queensland. William Jack Laughlin Dury from Queensland. Charles James Cyril Edwards from New South Wales. William David Fenton from Victoria. Shelby Skye Garnett from Western Australia. Fraser House from Western Australia. Jock Bailu McSmith from New South Wales. Alexander Craig Machos from South Australia. Jack Michael McCosker from Queensland. Benjamin Ross McCallum from Victoria. Georgia Ann McGrath from New South Wales. Oscar Donald McLean from Queensland. Fenella Milling from New South Wales. Lucy Helen Moore from Victoria. Jack Samuel Nelson from Victoria. Jack Francis O'Neill from New South Wales. Caitlin Alice Pound from Queensland. Madison Jane Ridgway from Victoria. Sophie Jane Stevens from New South Wales. Liberty Jane Walker from Queensland. Zachary Joe Webster from New South Wales. Thomas Weatherall from South Australia. Lachlan James Peter Zanka from South Australia. Your Excellency, the Graham McConnell Award for Business Planning is awarded to Caitlin Pound. The Marcus Oldham College Principals Award for Effort and Achievement is awarded to Jack McCosker. The Marcus Oldham College Chairman's Award to the Ducks of the Diploma of Agribusiness is awarded to Fraser House. Please congratulate the Diploma of Agribusiness 2018 graduates as they leave the stage. Your Excellency, the following students have satisfied the requirements for the Associate Degree of Agribusiness. Jack William Bartels from Tasmania. William Alexander Boyd from Victoria. Kyle William Bull from New South Wales. Jesse Allison Chandler from Queensland. James Leslie Cornish from South Australia. Nathan Howard Michael Denny from New South Wales. Isabel Ann Fenton from Queensland. Michael Seamus Giltrap from New South Wales. Lachlan Anthony Robert Gregory from New South Wales. Dana Jane Gray from Tasmania. Matthew Peter Hives from Victoria. Hamish McGuinness from New South Wales. Michael McManus from New South Wales. James Hamilton Ridge from New South Wales. Jenny Therese Swagger from New South Wales. Claudia Scarlett Turnbull from New South Wales. And Adelaide Vivas from New South Wales. Your Excellency, the Marcus Oldham College Old Students Association Award for Business Planning is awarded to Dana Gray. The G21 Agribusiness Forum Award for Strategic Planning is awarded to Isabel Fenton. The Marcus Oldham Principals Award for Effort and Achievement is awarded to Jesse Chandler. And the Mr. Robert Beggs AM and Mrs. Margaret Beggs Award to the Ducks of the Associate Degree of Agribusiness is awarded to Dana Gray. Please congratulate the Associate Degree of Agribusiness 2018 graduates as they leave the stage. Your Excellency, the following students have satisfied the requirements for the Associate Degree of Farm Business Management. Lachlan Murdoch Brown from Victoria. Samuel Robert Bungie from Victoria. Samuel William Peter Button from New South Wales. Thomas Clark from New South Wales. Sally Cullum Conway from Queensland. Jack David Courts from New South Wales. Kate Louise Crozier from Victoria. Joel Nicholas Kerr from New South Wales. Lachlan James Day from South Australia. Henry Thomas Dight from Queensland. Sam Dernan from New South Wales. Lucinda Nicola Fenton from Victoria. William Ferguson from Tasmania. Fergus Robert Ingalls from New South Wales. Sam Frederick Jackson from Western Australia. Hamish David Jannings from Western Australia. Tyler Sydney Lewis from Queensland. Cameron Lowe from South Australia. Hannah Margaret Allison Martindale from Victoria. James Thomas McCure from New South Wales. Jarrah McConaughey from Victoria. Peter Thomas McGrath from New South Wales. Dougal Morrison from Tasmania. Alexandra Mary McKay from Victoria. Andy Eloise Murphy from New South Wales. Holly Caitlin O'Regan from New South Wales. Sarah Diane Richards from Victoria. Jeremy Donald Robinson from New South Wales. Samuel Mark Sedgwick from Victoria. Megan Elizabeth Webb from Victoria. Sean Albert Preston Wright from Queensland. Curtis Jack Winhoven from Victoria. Your Excellency, The Geelong Colac Regional Mixed Commodity Branch of the Victorian Farmers Federation Award to the Student President is awarded to Jack Courts. The Bruce Kentish Memorial General Service Award for services to the college community is awarded to William Ferguson. The Incitec Pivot Limited Award for Farm Business Planning is awarded to Hannah Martindale. The Garth Massey Green Memorial Award for Farm Business Management is awarded to Sally Conway. The Ivo Dean Memorial Award for Agricultural Production and Technology is awarded to Megan Webb. The Marcus Oldham Principals Award for Effort and Achievement is awarded to Jack Courts. And the Marcus Oldham and the Pockley Award to the Ducks of the Associate Degree of Farm Business Management is awarded to Hannah Martindale. Please congratulate the Associate Degree of Farm Business Management 2018 graduates as they leave the stage. Your Excellency, the following students have satisfied the requirements for the Bachelor of Business, Agribusiness, Catherine Lucinda Bain from Victoria. Tegan Louise Bathgate from New South Wales. Sophie Georgia Bingham from Victoria. McKinley Oliver Cookson from New South Wales. Henry Charles Deans from South Australia. Nicola Ann Gilder from New South Wales. LJ Montana Hornery from Queensland. Ryan Richard Konzak from South Australia. Doon Mitchell from Queensland. Alice Mary Mort from Queensland. Brendan Paul Murray from New South Wales. Shingiray Nyabonda from Victoria. Jessica Louise Parker from Victoria. James Scott Richmond from Victoria. Alex Jordan Roberts from Queensland. Andrew Thomas Huntley Sloan from Victoria. Your Excellency, the Marcus Oldham Award to the Ducks of the Bachelor of Business Agribusiness is awarded to Jack Littler in absentia. Please congratulate the Bachelor of Business Agribusiness 2018 graduates as they leave the stage. Your Excellency, the following students have satisfied the requirements for the Bachelor of Business Agriculture. Archibald Douglas Bell from New South Wales. Jamie Douglas Deschen from Queensland. Timothy Finger from Victoria. Louis Van Niclerc Goosen from Victoria. Thomas Michael Grant from New South Wales. James Stuart Kirkpatrick from Victoria. L- Luke Peter Colbane Main from New South Wales. Genevieve Alexandra Norton from Victoria. William Maxwell Sanford from New South Wales. And Jonathan Robert Waterhouse from Victoria. Your Excellency, the Marcus Oldham Award to the Ducks of the Bachelor of Business Agriculture is awarded to Laura Wishart in absentia. Please congratulate the graduates of the Bachelor of Business Agriculture 2018 as they leave the stage.
I now invite Dr. Heather Davis, Director of Postgraduate Studies, to announce the Graduate Certificate of Agribusiness, the Graduate Diploma of Agribusiness, and Master of Agribusiness graduates.
Your Excellency, the following student has satisfied the requirements for the Graduate Certificate of Agribusiness. Sarah Frances Vimard, South Australia. Your Excellency, the following student has satisfied the requirements for the Graduate Diploma of Agribusiness, Victoria Elizabeth Mulcahy, Victoria. Your Excellency, the following student has satisfied the requirements for the Master of Agribusiness, Grant Donald Melrose, Queensland. Your Excellency, the Hassard Australia Award to the Ducks of the Master of Agribusiness this year is awarded to Grant Melrose. Please congratulate Sarah, Victoria and Grant as they leave the stage, and also all postgraduate students graduating in absentia today. Your Excellency, please be seated. Thank you.
The recipient of the 2018 Marcus Oldham Graduate of Excellence Award goes to Richard Longbottom. Richard attended Marcus Oldham College between 1992 and 1994 and graduated with a Diploma of Farm Management. Typical of a Marcus graduate, Richard worked for many years gaining valuable practical industry experience, which have served him well later in life. His career began at the age of 16 years, having grown up on the family sheep property in Narra Court, South Australia. He chose to go shearing and over a five-year period worked on properties in the Riverina, Broken Hill, Western Victoria and South Australia. But he realised along the way that he needed business management training to succeed in the future, and he enrolled at Marcus Oldham with a strong interest in the export sector. After graduation, he worked for the Costa Group, starting with the mundane jobs, but quickly moving into quality assurance roles, a fruit buyer, and export manager. In 2001, he started a fresh food export business called Walker Longbottom. 18 years on, the company now ships containers of fresh fruits to 35 countries throughout Asia, Middle East, India, Canada, and Russia. The main commodities are fresh grapes, mandarins, oranges, apples, stone fruit, and pears. Fruit is sourced from every state in Australia, New Zealand, the United States and Canada, and in the past, Argentina. Richard equates his success in business to four key points. Business is all about now, never tomorrow. Timing is crucial, quality is essential, and relationships are everything. With a continued love for the land, Richard has enjoyed more recently turning his hand to the restoration of a number of rundown farms in order to once again operate as profitable farming businesses. Richard is married to Kate and together they have two daughters. I now invite Adam Fletcher from Fairfax Agricultural Media and sponsor of the award to make the presentation to the 2018 Graduate of Excellence.
Thank you so much. There are so many great graduates doing great things. I'm honoured to be chosen for this award. If you had have told me in the 90s when I was shearing at Broken Hill, Hay, Hell and Booligal, that in 2001 I'd be running my own fruit exporting business, I would have said, you're mad. Marcus gave me the belief anything was possible. It gave me the skills to make anything possible. To all you here today, congratulations and well done. Your journey is well and truly on track. Now you have the means to do anything. Work hard and smart. Don't be afraid to start from the bottom. Work your way to the top. Ask lots of questions. Keep turning rocks until you find something interesting. Stay focused. Don't chop and change. You need to spend time in a sector to become valuable. When you make some money, save it. Don't spend it, tuck it away, invest it wisely, start accumulating some assets. Agriculture is looking as exciting as ever. Our neighbours to the north, India, Indonesia, China, the Middle East, are well and truly going through an economic revolution like the world has never seen, creating enormous opportunities for Australian farmers. It is your turn to make your mark on agriculture. You'll be farming with less water, more variable rainfall. You'll be righting some of the wrongs to the environment done by previous generations. You are the future entrepreneurs of agriculture. Through innovation, creativity, ingenuity, it is now up to you all here today to forge a new path for agriculture. Believe in yourself, stay determined. Keep persisting, never give up. Have a hunger for knowledge and information. From your own ideas, form your own ideas and opinions. Back yourself, have a go. Action and runs on the board are louder than talk. Get on with it, don't think it over, just do it. Honesty and integrity, you trade on your reputation. If you ruin this, you have nothing. Time and knowledge will reward hard workers. To the friends and staff from The friends and staff from Marcus Oldham are friends for life. We're so lucky to be part of the Marcus Oldham community. As Graham Burnham said to us in our final weeks in third year, the most important decision you make is the partner you choose. If you get this right, everything else looks pretty easy. If you're going home to the farm, work out whose it is. The next 20 years are your foundation years. You can't afford to lose them. And in the meantime, have fun. It's not all that serious. Thank you.
The success of Marcus Oldham College over its 56-year history is attributed in part to the students, staff, ethos, and uniqueness of the institution. But the success of Marcus Oldham is also due to the significant contribution from individuals who provide time and valuable input into the organisation. A major contributor to Marcus Oldham College's success will be acknowledged for his great efforts today. The College awards an honorary degree at this year's graduation to Mr. Ian Farron. Successful organisations are built on culture. For Marcus Oldham, Ian Farron has been a key influencer of a positive culture over a sustained period of close to 25 years. Ian has lectured in agricultural engineering over this time and provided the agriculture students with a wonderful insight into how theory can be applied to practice. With qualifications in agriculture, engineering, agribusiness and computing, Ian has been well placed to impart significant knowledge to our students. Ian has had an extensive career working as industry consultant, and he has been instrumental during his lecturing time in establishment of Pastoral Pork Company, the Western Plains Pork Company, and Otway Pork Processing, of which he is currently the managing director. Ian is highly regarded by both staff and students, always encouraging students to do their best and keen that they represent the college at the highest level. I would now like to ask Mr. Richard Warner, who was also a graduate of 1970, even before I started at the college, to present the Honorary Bachelor of Business Agriculture degree, signifying Ian's dedication and commitment to Marcus Oldham College.
Your Excellency and Marcus Oldham College extended family. I would like to thank Bruce and his team, the College Council, for this award and their support over my time at Marcus Oldham College. The councillors all provide their time freely and are very passionate about our college today and its future, as we can see on campus today with the development of the new learning centre. I'd like to congratulate those graduating with me today. We have had an interesting year. My first knowledge of Marcus Oldham College was in 1966. A lot of you weren't born then. When I was coached in the eighth rowing eight at Geelong Grammar by the first Marcus Oldham Farm Management College principal, Ive O'Dean, when he remembered to turn up. The college commenced in 1962, and Ive O'Dean was initially charged with the responsibility of establishing the college. He developed a set of principles to support the ethos for the college, many of which remain today. Students would be required to have at least 1 year of practical experience since leaving school. I think nowadays they call that the gap year. Students would be selected on matriculation results, ATAR or whatever you might want to call that today, age, practical experience, academic level, and personal interview. Practical experience learning opportunities would be embedded in the course, the prac year, industry placement, as still happens in the courses today. Students would be exposed to a range of farming systems through tours, visits, and case studies. Students would have continuous assessment opportunities rather than final exams. I believe in my time at Marcus that I've been able to continue to apply Ivo's principles for the college and the students, and as Ivo did, have some fun. Having been at the college for a number of years, there are lots of stories. However, we have an unofficial rule that what happens on tour stays on tour unless Simon finds out. I've continued to do some rowing over the years, and it is the ultimate team sport, trying to get eight rowers to think and do the same thing in the boat. so it is balanced, going faster, while you are actually going backwards. We sometimes experience this in agriculture when our particular industry is at the bottom of the cycle. A highlight of my time at Marcus was to have a Marcus crew win the Victorian State Eight Oared Rowing Championship, although it was only the D grade. I'd like to acknowledge the great support I've received from Simon and previous principals of the college and the current and past teams of dedicated staff, the academics, let's say lecturers, administration, marketing and support staff, Lynn and her team, and maintenance, those that make the college happen every day. I would like to acknowledge my cousin Andrew Farron, a wool grower from Edenhope, who for 10 years has provided the Yadinga Scholarship to assist students with an interest in the sheep industry to attend the college. Three of these students are graduating today. I applied for a pig industry travel scholarship in 1975. A 25-year-old with a Master's of Agricultural Engineering, just graduated, knew everything. Sounds familiar for the new graduates. I didn't receive the award. They said they didn't think I would be in the pig industry for very long. Forty-three years later, I'm delivering Otway pork cutlets to the Coles DC in Victoria and New South Wales 6 days a week, living the dream. While the agro politicians awarding the travel scholarship had left the pig industry within 8 years. Make sure you get the message. Finally, I would like to acknowledge the support of my wife, Robin, who, as always, thinking of others, regularly asking if I have completed my marking. May Marcus Oldham College continue to be the best in Australia at providing farm management, agribusiness and equine education for generations of Australian agriculturalists to come, and for you, the graduates today, and our future graduates to be able to live their dreams. Thank you for the experience.
It is my pleasure today to introduce today's guest speaker, Tasmania's 28th Governor, Her Excellency Professor the Honourable Kate Warner, AC. Her Excellency was sworn into office at Government House on Wednesday, 10th of December 2014. Previously, she was Professor, Faculty of Law at the University of Tasmania and Director of the Tasmania Law Reform Institute. She had also, in her career at the university, held the positions of Dean, Faculty of Law, and Head of School. Following her appointment as Governor, she was made a Professor Emeritus. On the 26th of January 2014, Her Excellency was appointed a member of the Order of Australia for her significant service to the law, particularly in the areas of law reform and education. On the 26th of January 2017, she was appointed a Companion of the Order of Australia for her eminent service to the people of Tasmania through leading contributions to the legal community, to law reform, to higher education as an academic, researcher and publisher, and as a supporter of the arts and environmental and social justice initiatives. Her teaching interests included criminal law, evidence, criminology and sentencing. And her research interests included sentencing and criminal justice. Since her appointment as governor, she has continued her research, particularly into sentencing. In addition to working with the Tasmania Law Reform Institute on its projects, she has been involved in providing advice and submissions on the rape law reform, drug diversion and mental health diversion programs, and abortion law reform. She has also assisted other law reform bodies nationally, including the New South Wales Law Reform Commission and the Australian Law Reform Commission. Your Excellency, I invite you to deliver the graduation address.
Thank you, Bruce, and good afternoon, everyone, and thanks so much for inviting me to speak today. Can I begin by acknowledging the Wadawurrung people, the traditional owners of the land on which we meet, and pay respects to their elders past and present. And can I also acknowledge among you Bruce Wilson, Chair of the Marcus Oldham College Council, and Simon Livingston, Principal of Marcus Oldham College. So it's a great pleasure for me to be here today, though you must wonder, having heard a little bit of my CV, what on earth am I going to talk to you about today? But of course, Dick and I do have a connection with Marcus Oldham. Dick is a graduate, and I have to say, 50 years or so ago, I visited Marcus Oldham at a function, attending a woolshed ball with Dick, and I'm not sure that I should elaborate too much on that particular occasion, which was very memorable because of what happened to my beautiful new leather coat that I'd been given for my 21st birthday. I foolishly left it on a bed. I won't say any more. So what a wonderful contribution this college has made to educating the agricultural sector in Australia. From its commencement in 1962, Marcus has led the way in presenting graduates to the market who are work ready and capable in the rapidly changing world of agriculture. Whether it's managing a family farm, managing a corporate farming business, working in finance, logistics, marketing, processing, or the equine industry, Marcus Oldham equips individuals well. Including today's graduates, there have been 3,459 graduates from all Marcus Oldham courses. And included in that tally are 176 Tasmanians. And 969 students completed the equine management course, which commenced in 1979. And that year, courses were also open to women. And I have to say, it was great to see so many women graduating with agricultural degrees today. I know also that the business management emphasis embedded into Marcus courses has enabled many graduates to find successful careers away from agriculture. So agriculture is facing unprecedented challenges, with the global population expected to reach over 9 billion by 2050. In addition, it is estimated that another 1 billion people will move out of poverty into middle-class living standards in the same period, further increasing the demand for food. This means that in the first half of this century, the world will need to produce more food than we have in the rest of the history of human civilization. This does not mean simply growing more, because farming needs to take into account restrictions on land and water use, meeting environmental concerns, and maintaining what is termed a social license to produce. Our Australian farms and farmers are very efficient, but they will, of necessity, need to become even more efficient in the future. We will need to grow more with less and also decrease waste throughout the food chain. Concepts such as the circular economy have great relevance to agriculture, where I understand it to mean that we must use a minimal amount of external inputs, called, I think, precision agriculture, close nutrient loops and reduce discharge to the environment, and valorise agri-food wastes, which I understand to mean optimising the quality of side streams. Reading all about this, I realised that there is really nearly as much jargon and discipline-specific language in agriculture as in law, which is really famous for it. Lawyers and judges, in particular, relish the use of Latin phrases, particularly when no one else can understand them. Things like res ipsa loquitur, valenti non fit injuria, and nunc pro tunc. I do remember as a young lawyer hearing a judge ask counsel, are you nunc pro tunc? No, actually it was, am I nunc pro tunc? And I was just so glad that I wasn't the person having to answer that question because I had no idea what he was talking about. And this can all be very terrifying for young practitioners. And I really like the story of a young lawyer in the magistrate's court who was really struggling to come up with an appropriate response to the magistrate who had asked him about curfew conditions attached to a reconnaissance and whether or not his client was happy to accept them. So as he struggled to come up with some kind of appropriate response to the magistrate, somebody from the bar table whispered, just mention section 6 of the Boundary Fences Act. So thinking he'd been thrown a lifeline, he responded, oh, I refer your honour to section 6 of the Boundary Fences Act. But the magistrate's quizzical frown and the mirth from the bar table made him quickly realise that this was no lifeline. But back to the challenges of agriculture. What do they mean for the graduates of 2018? The Australian Council of Deans of Agriculture found that for each graduate of an agricultural-related degree, there are 6 jobs available. As new technologies radically improve efficiencies and outputs of our farms, they also create a new reality where those who do not embrace these changes face the risk of being left behind. Vertical farms, smart farms, and factory farms may not be as romantic as rolling green hills, but they are efficient and they are a glimpse of the farms of tomorrow. Already we have driverless tractors and drones helping to monitor animals and conditions in the field. And in Japan, for example, Toshiba is growing 3 million heads of lettuce per year in a room where air pressure, water, light, temperature, bacteria, and dust are strictly controlled. While here in Australia, the University of Sydney is developing a range of robots to work field crops and orchards. The likelihood of a food crisis directly affecting Australia is remote, given that we have enjoyed cheap, safe, and high-quality food for many decades. And we currently produce enough food for 60 million people. However, putting this into a global context, we produce enough to feed only 2% of the Asian population. Australia will continue to play an important role in the provision of food security worldwide. Our farmers, with support from world-leading research and development programs, will continue to provide innovation and productivity gains in all sectors. According to the Agribusiness Bulletin, a newsletter of Deloitte Access Economics, it is that sector, agribusiness, which is now a key sector in driving growth opportunities for the Australian economy. And I'm just quoting from an article early this year. It said, of all the sectors in the Australian economy, agribusiness is the sector with the strongest combination of playing most to Australia's competitive advantage and being a sector producing what the world increasingly wants. And in this regard, Deloitte has identified the Fantastic Five of Australian agriculture as being beef, lamb, aquaculture, dairy, and oilseeds. Tasmanian graduates make up 5% of all Marcus graduates, and many have gone on to do remarkable things. Tasmania is a small business state with high level of dependence on niche marketing. It has developed strong brand resilience and is quickly developing a reputation for high-quality products which attract premium prices necessary to offset logistical challenges. Many of Marcus Oldham graduates, Tasmanian graduates, have made significant contributions towards Tasmania's renewed agricultural prosperity. And just to name a few, Matthew Pawley is prominent in the rapidly expanding Tasmanian wine industry. Jack Sadler helped significantly put Tasmanian floriculture on the Australian market. Howard Hansen is doing extraordinary things with cherries and apples. Emma Sutherland is business manager of Burlington Berries, one of Tasmania's fastest growing and sophisticated horticultural businesses. And George Mills is showing the way in sustainable cropping and livestock production. The current Tasmanian state government has implemented an agricultural growth strategy to lift the gross value of agriculture from $1.5 billion to $10 billion by 2050. And that is a serious challenge and one which will provide opportunities for many graduates in the future. So agricultural expertise is not only valuable here in our country. Some of our near neighbours face enormous challenges feeding their people with nutritious food. In East Timor, Timor-Leste, for example, where half the population is undernourished, my husband Dick has been working with the Crawford Foundation to improve horticultural practices and to change the crops that are grown so they grow more nutritious food. I'm aware that Marcus Oldham College, Australia's only independent agricultural and equine business management college, has not only survived but has thrived and has moved with the times by adding new courses, including postgraduate studies. Furthermore, the college runs a leadership program which is supported by NAB Agribusiness. Over 780 students have now graduated from the five-day intensive which commenced in 1992. Leadership is, I think, a vital attribute for the delivery of outcomes which are so necessary for agriculture to achieve its potential in the years ahead. And Marcus Oldham College delivers that very well indeed. So agriculture's mission is to feed the world. You are going to have many opportunities to contribute to this mission and to do so in ways that, as I said, grows more from less and which keeps profit motives in check by managing our resources for future generations. My generation has had a very poor record in this regard, and I hope that you will learn from our mistakes. So my congratulations to all of you who have made this college such a successful and important part of Australia's agricultural education. You have contributed enormously to agricultural development in this country and will continue to do so. The task ahead remains significant, as only 7% of Australian farmers have tertiary education, compared with 20% in New Zealand and 40% in the United States. So in conclusion, let me just quote from Mr. Don Lawson, OAM, a former lecturer here. He said, "We need to attract people to all sections of the agricultural supply chain. We need young people with academic qualifications and hands-on skills. It is disturbing that 25% of the Australian community has tertiary qualifications, yet in the agricultural sector, it is about 7%. I would suggest," he said, "that after the mining industry has dug a big hole in Australia, what are we going to have left? Agriculture. Practical agriculture needs people with both practical skills and tertiary education. And so that is why we're here today. So I would like to congratulate all of the graduates today. It is wonderful that you have achieved this, and so celebrate it. Thank you."
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That concludes our graduation ceremony today. We hope you'll join us for refreshments out in the foyer outside. After the retiring procession, could the honorary degree, the Graduate of Excellence, award winners, course duxes, and course directors please make their way into the foyer where they'll have their official photographs taken. Would you please stand while the academic procession and the graduates leave the hall? Thank you very much for being here with us.
Well,